Welcome to Chemistry Laboratory at Modesto Junior College. We want to make sure you have a safe laboratory experience here. Lab safety begins before you even get into the room. You must make sure you're properly dressed because your clothing is the first line of defense against broken glass, hot liquids, or corrosive substances. You must be covered at least to your shoulders, so no tank tops. Long sleeves are not required, but a good idea. Long pants are required. No shorts, capris, distressed jeans, holes, or mesh panels. Legs must be completely covered. Feet must also be completely covered. Tops, sides, backs. Uh-oh, are those low-cut socks? Your ankle's exposed. What if glassware breaks right next to where you're standing? Lab Monkey does not approve. Do you have a pair of longer socks in your bag or car or something? Okay, great. Now you're ready to go to lab. You might have some food or beverages with you. They must be put away before entering the room. This includes gum. Please get rid of your gum. If your beverage is not spill-proof, you must store it in the chemistry corridor. Do not put it down on the lab bench. It could be contaminated. Do not take one last sip inside the lab room. Do not pass go. Do not collect $200. Go directly to the corridor. That's it. Also, do not place your phone on the bench because you're probably not going to wash it if it gets contaminated. Okay. I appreciate the thought, but having it on top of a paper or book is not much better. Something can still spill on it. Nope, still not safe. I am not even sure what to say about that one. You do like your phone, don't you? Put it away in your bag. And while you're at it, you should put your bag itself where it can't get stuff spilled on it, not on the bench, the stool, or the floor near your bench. Check with your professor to see if the front of the room is acceptable to them. Another personal item that should not be on the bench is glasses or sunglasses. I think we covered that too. Now don't put those on your face again until you've washed them thoroughly. Something that should be on your face is safety goggles. Not just impact glasses, they should seal around the face. They can be unvented, but that gets humid. If vented, they should be indirectly vented. The vents need to be shielded and not lead directly to the eye area. Also, vents should not be removed or modified to provide a direct opening to the eye area. You should store your goggles in a clean plastic bag in your drawer. If they are placed on the bench or in your drawer without a plastic bag, they should be washed before use. You are finally in lab with your stuff put away and goggles on your face. Next, be sure to familiarize yourself with all the safety equipment and where it is located. Each of the sinks has an eye wash, and there is a standalone eye wash in the corner of the room. If you get any contamination into your eye, be sure to flush it for several minutes. If you see another student using the eye wash, please notify the instructor. The student may need help holding their eye open. The corner also has a safety shower and an emergency gas shutoff. The safety shower should be used if someone has a corrosive spill over a large area of their clothing or is on fire. The alarm will sound, and all students should turn off any heating elements and leave through the other door to give the student privacy. Another option to put out a clothing fire is the fire blanket. We also have a fire extinguisher, first aid kit, and phone with emergency contact numbers. Notify the instructor of any incidents, accidents, or injuries, even minor ones. Proper disposal of broken glass is an important safety issue. We do not want any students or staff to be injured because of broken glass in the trash. All broken glass pieces should go into the labeled container. We will be working with Bunsen burners and hot plates. Never leave an experiment unattended while it is being heated. If you use a match to light the burner, it should go in the red ceramic crock. Paper towels and other papers should not be in those crocks. Otherwise, well, we could have seen that coming. Don't panic. Just cover it like you would a grease fire in a pan at home. And please be sure to notify the instructor as well. Before you turn on a hot plate, check to make sure that the cord is not too close to the heated surface. You can see what happens when they do get too close. Try to keep our equipment in working order. Speaking of equipment, we need to be considerate of our expensive digital balances also. Never scoop or pour any solids or liquids onto the balance. remove the beaker or other container in order to transfer the solid or liquid, then put it back onto the balance to get the mass. Many compounds react with air or moisture. Always put lids back onto the containers. If you do pour out too much of a substance, never pour it back into the container. Your beaker could be contaminated. The extra substance should be disposed of properly or shared with another student. Be sure to keep the balance area and all of the work areas in the lab clean. Wipe up any spills. Many instructors will deduct points from the entire class if the lab is left in an unacceptable condition. Remember to read your lab experiment before you arrive so you know of any specific safety or disposal concerns. And pay attention to the pre-lab lecture. Be aware of your surroundings and use common sense. We want everyone to have a safe and enjoyable laboratory experience. Thank you for your cooperation.